Okay guys, this is my walkthrough on how to use the Dolphin 3.0 emulator, GameCube and Wii emulator. As I could see on YouTube and a lot of other places, people are always looking for ways to speed up their FPS, and I actually found a very, very good way. Now, I have a normal computer. I spent maybe $800 to a grand on it. I have a decent graphics card, and alone, on its own, without any tweaks or boosts or anything like that, I get about maybe 35 FPS and about 43 game speed. Now, there's a lot of factors they have to think about when you are emulating newer generation systems along the lines of Xbox, PlayStation 2, and GameCube. Well, the main one that you need to think about is your background processes, and I'm going to go into this right now. What I'll do first is I will show you Game Booster. Game Booster goes in and stops all of your pretty much unnecessary processes for gaming. Now, this is solely for gaming. I'm not too sure how much it affects anything else because I haven't even tried to use any of these programs. So, yeah. What I'll do first is I'm going to turn off Game Booster, and then I will show you the FPS that I'm getting with my games, and I'm going to do this using Soul Calibur. In later walkthroughs, I'm actually going to go through Soul Calibur 2 for the GameCube. Let me grab my controller here, and I'm actually going to do character walkthroughs and how to use them in the main ways to fight with them. Okay, so I'm just going to go ahead and turn on Dolphin. Now you'll notice, without Game Booster, I'm going to be running pretty slow. I'm running at my internal resolution. As you can see, I'm getting about 34, peaking about 40 FPS right now. But once I get into the game itself, it'll drop considerably. As you can see, it's running very, very slow. I'm running about 20, 24 FPS. I'll go ahead and skip through that, get to gameplay. Now, at the main menus, I'm getting pretty good reaction here. Reaction time's pretty nice. And I get these as well. And I'm sure a lot of people do. This is desynchronization of the game because it's running so slow. I'm getting a run speed of about 70%. Now the game is going to quit working at this point, and that's a sad thing. Now the thing you need to keep in mind is that is that if you don't have a decent graphics card, this will not work for you, and no other method will whatsoever. Okay, now I'm going to turn Game Booster back on. This is a freeware program, and in the installation process, it will ask you to add like toolbars and stuff like that, but you can just skip right through all that. You don't have to do it. Okay, now that I'm running Game Booster, right here. Now that I'm running Game Booster, you'll see a significant increase in my game speed. I'll be running 100%. Sometimes I even get about 130%. As you can see, it's running very nicely.
Transcending history and the world.
And this is Game Booster. About the only thing I can see that actually works very well. It really does. It works greatly. As you can see, it's beautiful. Now, I think it's running a bit slow because I'm running Camtasia at the moment. But without any other background programs running, this game runs absolutely perfect. It's amazing. And this is Game Booster. I'm actually running pretty slow because of Camtasia, but you can see that I'm getting great FPS out of this. And yeah, this is the this is the game with Game Booster. Now, this doesn't only just work with game like emulators and stuff. It works with your games as well, like World of Warcraft, League of Legends, Bloodline Champions. And just doing a little bit of a plug on Game Booster because it is a very amazing program. You know, log out of Dolphin for now. I'm going to show you how to get Game Booster. Just go to Google. And I don't know the exact website name, so I'm just going to Google Game Booster. Like so. And you'll see right here, Game Booster 3.0 free download. Da-da-da. Sorry for the background noise. I have my window open. Click here to download for free. It'll take you to this forums page, and yes, this is the download button. I know that it looks like an advertisement, but it's not. But you go ahead and you just click that, and it'll give you the setup. Now, I don't want this, but you just go through there, and you set it up. It's very easy. Make sure that you have a launch icon on your desktop, and you're done. Just go ahead and hit boost. And yeah, that concludes this tutorial for how to speed up your GameCube, PlayStation 2, Xbox emulator. Thanks.